Today, we're taking a look at some more songs with the same title and deciding on which song is the best. Let's get started. So we got Attention by Charlie Puth versus by The Weeknd versus by Joji versus XXXTentacion. You just want attention. That breakdown with just the bass. Baby, you just hate the thought of me with someone new. I have such a hard time believing that any other song called Attention is gonna be better than this. A lot of people might argue that See You Again made Charlie Puth, and that's, I guess, true, but it would have been so easy for him to become just a one-hit wonder. But this song was the song that really made him a mainstay in the pop scene. It's so good. Tell me how to love, it's been so long. That vocal in the background is weird. And you just need to talk. You're looking for attention. You only notice it cause I'm actually rocks. I really like that. I've never heard it before, but it was really good. Actually similar qualities to Attention by Charlie Puth in that the chorus melody was really strong and like really like, you just wanted an attention. I love it. Girl, would it kill you just to throw a little bit of attention? Is he mumbling or what? Now would you hate me if I ran like hell and the wind from dawn till dies? It's funny when you have no idea what someone's singing almost. I heard Attention in there. Maybe he recorded this right after getting dental surgery. That's why he's smiling so big in the picture as well. He's showing off his dental surgery teeth. I don't think that's a front runner. We'll see though. Production's dope. Is he singing about himself? Attention. No, it's just a shortened Attention. That makes more sense. He had a cool voice, 100%. The winner among songs called Attention is Charlie Puth. What an incredible song. It would be a weird flex now to write a song called Attention that's better than Charlie Puth's one. All songwriters there at home, write a better song called Attention right now and you will fail. But it's okay because pretty sure Charlie Puth couldn't write another song better than Attention called Attention either. Next up, we got Bang Bang by Jessie J, Ariana Grande, and Nicki Minaj versus Bang Bang by Cher versus Bang Bang by will.i.am. This one was obviously a massive hit. I feel like Bang Bang is the default choice here if the other ones don't wow me. Sick. Oh no, sound effects on the music video. My pet peeve. Why? It just means you can't listen to the music video like music. Like, oh yeah, a little bit of skateboard sounds, a little bit of freaking driving a taxi. Maybe it is just because that. You put some cars in, you put some skateboards in. Yeah, now you gotta listen to it on Spotify, you little dingus. You would always win me by bang bang. You shut me down, bang bang. I hit the ground. It sounds like a soundtrack for like a cowboy movie or something. That awful sound, bang bang. My baby shut me down. And here we have definitely the ultimate one, will.i.am. I don't know, I love will.i.am. He's done some good stuff, but the average level of will.i.am music is very low. I love her, can't leave her, forever I always need her. She lied, but I believe her. Love sick, I got that fever. Love stupid, fun. I know it. Love stupid, I know it. I know, cause I'm a fool in love. My baby shot me down again. Shot me down with a love and it go bang bang. I'm such a sucker for that type of jazz samples and stuff in popular music, but he kind of ruined it there in the middle. Okay, now it's weird. It has to go to Jessie J, Nicki Minaj, Ariana Grande, Bang Bang. Big tune. By the way, welcome back to another daily video. My name's Joel from Roomie Official, and here's a meme from the subreddit. Roomies over the last 2 weeks. Joel in hotel room setup. Joel posing on the bed. Joel taking a break to rest. Joel wears a new shirt. Yeah, that's what you guys are talking about. It's never about the videos anymore, is it? It's just like, oh, what is Joel wearing? I'm actually wearing a new shirt right now. There should be some good memes for Reddit. Check it out. I'm wearing new pants. Oh, this is a good one. So we got Dynamite by BTS versus Dynamite by Tyah Cruz, which is an absolute classic as well, versus Dynamite by Westlife. I didn't even know Westlife still made music. I talked about this song in more detail in this video, so if I don't seem like I have a lot to say, it's because I said it already. I throw my hands up in the air sometimes, saying hey. Yeah, it's a tune. There were so many great covers of this, I remember. That melody just sounds great when anyone sings it.
I throw my hands up in the air sometimes, saying, hey, oh, gotta let go.
And if we fall,
very low-key. They've really gotten into singing for the 40-year-olds now, which is fine. Nothing wrong with singing for 40-year-olds. Okay, not very exciting maybe for the younger generation. For our winner of Dynamite, I have to say Tayo Cruz's Dynamite. While I do like the BTS song, I think it's a little bit forgettable. I don't think it's gonna be one of BTS's biggest hits over time when they release more English music. Dynamite has just stood the test of time. It's already old, still amazing, just timeless. Those melodies are insane. Next up, we got a bunch of songs called Tell Me Why. Tell Me Why by Taylor Swift, Elvis Presley, The Beatles, Spice Girls, Genesis, and Jonas Brothers. This is Taylor Swift's country period, which really wasn't really country. Like, it's just pop with some, like, ooh, let's add a slide guitar. Now it's country.
Tell me why does it hurt so bad?
Is this from the TV show, The Jonas Brothers? This feels too low quality to be an actual music video.
Tell me why you cry and why you lie to me.
Wow. They sound like the Beach Boys there.
Tell me why.
How 90s is this?
Mothers crying in the street. Children dying at their feet. Tell me why. Tell me why.
While that was heavy, just listing a bunch of sad things and then saying tell me why. Like, it doesn't come across as super deep to me. It's more like you want to say important things, but what are you really saying? I want to give music that's trying to say something important a shot, but it needs to be done well. Taylor Swift and Jonas Brothers live in the same land of like mass manufactured rock pop stuff. Then we got Spice Girls, which was just the most 90s thing you've ever heard. I gotta give it to the Beatles, even though they very much sounded like the Beach Boys in this one. It was cozy. I enjoyed listening to it. Here we got Someone Like You by Adele versus Someone Like You by Van Morrison.
It is nowhere. Never mind, I'll find someone like you.
Yeah. Amazing vocal take. I do think that that piano playing also adds something to that song, honestly. A lot of these piano ballads will have very bassline piano playing, like the type of piano playing I can do, like. But this is like. It's got a little bit of an arpeggio vibe to it. Okay, here we got Van Morrison.
Someone exactly like you.
Ah, this is cozy.
Make it all worthwhile. Someone like you. Keep me satisfied. Someone exactly like you.
I'm a sucker for romantic songs like that, I gotta say. And that Adele song never really sat right with me. I gotta give it to Van Morrison. I wanna listen to that now and just think of my dream girl. Lame, just kidding, I'm a man. Why would I think about a girl? Next up, we have Dancing in the Moonlight by King Harvest versus Dancing in the Moonlight by Thin Lizzy. As opposed to Thick Lizzy, am I right?
Get it almost every
night. Favorite freaking song.
When that moon gets so big and bright, it's
so good.
Natural delight. Every border was dancing in the moonlight.
Dancing in the moonlight.
Backing vocals are a little bit pitchy. I think if they weren't, this would have been the superior version. But because everything's a little bit wonky, I would say that the cover is slightly better, but we're not comparing covers here, are we? We're comparing songs.
I should have took that last bus home, but I asked you for a dance. But I'm dancing in the moonlight. It's got me the spotlight.
The sax. Oh, that's cheesy as heck. It has to go to King Harvest. Classic banger. By the way, we got merch. Check out this merch. Check out this merch. I'm saving money to buy Rednecks the band so that they can do the hula ha in the background when I do my video. Check out this simulation. Oh, I love when Rednecks is doing the hula ha behind me. Buy the merch for that. Great. Thanks. Next up, we got Story of My Life by One Direction versus Story of My Life by Social Distortion.
Where did I been holding on too tight? With nothing in between. The story of my life, I take her home. I dive all night to keep her warm in time.
Harry always had a great voice.
And time is frozen.
I didn't have much interest in sports or school elections.
You know he thinks he's cool. Yeah, it has to go to One Direction. What was that? Honestly, I get it. It's a subculture, but it's a subculture I don't like. Fight me in the comments. Fight me. Next up, we got I'm Yours by Jason Mraz, big classic, versus I'm Yours by Alessia Cara, versus I'm Yours by Elvis Presley.
Well, you done me, and you bet I felt it. I tried to beat you, but you.
Very overplayed song, like we talked about in this video.
Now I'm trying to get back.
Still good.
Hey, it's a arte no more, no more. It cannot wait. I'm yours.
Some nerve you have to break up my lonely and tell me you want me. How dare you march into my heart? Oh, how rude of you. But I told you.
Pretty average pop. I don't really see anything that stands out here. She's got a good voice. I got a feeling she's got better songs, but this one in particular, eh.
My heart and all it can give.
Beautiful.
For just as long as I live.
Sounds like grandparents hooking up.
I'm yours.
You can see your grandpa lip-syncing that to your grandma. Be real with me. It has to go to Jason Mraz, I'm Yours. It's a very overplayed song, but it does have a lot of quality. There's a reason it's been played so much. Next up, we got What Is Love by Hathaway versus What Is Love by Howard Jones versus What Is Love by Twice.
What is right? What is wrong? Give me a sign.
So good.
What is love?
Amazing. I'm so happy he didn't wear a shirt. It makes it way better.
I love you even if you think that I don't. Anyway, does anybody love anybody anyway? What's love? Anyway,
I don't like that. They tried to get everything 80s in there, but it's still not good in the same way that a lot of 80s music was. Not my favorite. That was solid girl pop. Solid. Real good. I enjoyed that a lot. I'm gonna have to do something crazy. I love Hathaway and What Is Love, but I gotta give it to Twice. That was solid girl pop, and I kind of have to go put it on my girl pop playlist right now. Okay, guys, get care for more music commentary videos, get care for music VS videos, and I will see you tomorrow in another daily video. Here's another meme from the subreddit. Hope has left the chat. That full second when you thought the new little pitchy music had dropped, and then it's promo for Living For That. It's coming, guys, it's coming. 2023. I'm kidding. It'll come as soon as possible. Bye.